Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to a special episode of Game Time. I'm once again playing an unofficial PETA parody game. Today, it's Pokémon Red, White, and Blue. Now, in the past, I've featured their other parody games, Black and Blue and Super Mario Tanooki Skin, which have been some of my most popular episodes of Game Time. So if you want to get caught up, I definitely suggest checking those videos out. Links are in the description. But wouldn't you know it, the People for Ethical Treatment of Animals have released yet another RPG spoof available to play for free, a Flash game on their website, which not only lampoons Pokémon X and Y, but also throws McDonald's under the bus. Let's click the play button and see what they have in store.
For generations, humans have claimed to love Pokémon, but if Pokémon came to our world in real life and saw how we treat animals, would they love us back? Would they feel that Pokémon games have a part in reducing our empathy for animals? Would they feel like it's completely ridiculous that Pokémon releases two versions of essentially the same game and then as he does it, he releases slightly different versions a couple of years later? And what would humans do to Pokémon if they got their hands on them in the real world? Dun 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 dum! Let's begin the game. A battle is in progress. Are you too late to help? No, because that would be a terrible way to begin a game.
I've told you four times already, you old cow. We own you.
Mysterious stranger uses dehorning.
Oh, no, he's gonna poach me.
Injured Militank. Why would you do this to me? Didn't your mother teach you about kindness?
My mother taught me Pokemon are mine to abuse in any way I want, and right now I want to satisfy my hungry customers.
Oh, he's supposed to be the Hamburglar. I didn't actually pick that up.
Mysterious stranger uses butcher.
Ow!
Injured Miltank faints.
Pikachu enters the battle!
I can't believe you think it's okay to feed Miltank to people. Prepare for trouble!
Alright, how to play? Okay, I know how to play. I've done this before. Alright, fight!
Group hug! Charge beam!
Ooh, right in the groin!
Mysterious stranger stunned with a powerful laser beam.
He became paralyzed. He may not be able to move. He's paralyzed. He can't move. All right. We'll keep fighting. This time, we'll go with
slam attack. Boom! Shagalaga! Pikachu courageously slammed the mysterious stranger. Mysterious stranger uses dehorning.
Pikachu doesn't have any horns, buddy. What are you doing? You're wasting your punishment powers.
Not very effective, like I thought.
Group hug time.
Oh, I love you and your Hamburglar ways.
Pikachu smothered Mysterious Stranger with a loving embrace.
Mysterious Stranger's defense fell.
Mysterious Stranger uses Dehorning. Is that his only move?
Dude, get a new attack. You're boring me.
Mysterious Stranger dished out punishment to Pikachu. It's not very effective. Let's try Charge Beam again. That one seemed to be like a pretty good move, so activate.
Yay!
Pikachu stunned Mysterious Stranger with a powerful laser beam, and the people of Unova eat Pokemon, do they not?
Only occasionally. We're fighting to change that. Everyone knows it's gross. Where I come from, we eat each other beings all the time. We're taught as children that we're the masters of the world. We use lesser beings as our entertainment, our clothing, and even our food.
Especially squirrels, those furry little marmots.
Pokemon Universe reinforces this message by teaching us that Pokemon are humans' property to use and abuse however they wish.
Again, I am editorializing here, but I don't think that's what they're teaching or reinforcing.
And you, Pikachu, play a bigger role in this than you understand.
That's not what Pokemon are about. We exist for our own purpose. So just go back to wherever you came from, the sewer most likely, and leave us alone.
Mysterious stranger fell.
Miltank joins the party despite the fact that he's dead. So we'll call him Milftank.
Because I have a sixth grader sense of humor.
Thanks for having compassion for me.
Mysterious stranger.
Be seeing you, Pokemon.
Mysterious stranger disappears through a curious portal.
What? He got the portal gun and we don't?
Weird crossover.
Look, he's left something behind. Pikachu found a chest. Let's open it up and see what's in there. A cartridge was inside. Ooh, you've unlocked a bonus video. Oh, the cartridge reads For Your Eyes Only, Secret Master Plan.
Factory farming in 60 seconds flat.
I know those sound effects. They're from the iMovie library.
Oh man, check it out, chickens. That's gonna be my dinner later tonight. They look like they're being abused.
It's very curiously edited, to be completely honest with you. Alright, let's close the video before I start feeling emotion. Oh my god, so this is McDonald's Corporation is killing Pokemon to feed them to animals? What? Huh? McDonald's? Pokemon? I
I love their french fries. I don't think those Pokemon they were killing. Humans kill whoever they want, however they want. But just because they are all different from us, it doesn't mean we should ignore it.
Exactly. We have to stop these people from eating other beings, and we have to stop this McDonald's corporation.
Okay, so let's just take a time out here. PETA, are you actually suggesting that all 7.1 billion people on this planet go to a vegetarian diet only? I do not think that is a healthy decision for mankind. I don't know that we as carnivores could sustain on that global level only on fruits and vegetables. I feel like protein, iron, and meat is something we need in our diet. Regardless of animal abuse views, I feel like you're giving the wrong message. Let's roll out! Maybe we should just walk.
That's funny. That's a joke. That's a joke. That's what that was.
All right. Whoa, where are we? We're somewhere else. Are we in Pokemon X and Y? Nope. This is where the mysterious stranger was from. I see a giant yellow M up ahead. That must be McDonald's, where they turn living, feeling beings into food for unkind humans. Are you calling me unkind? I love myself one of them Angus burgers, and that does not make me a bad person. What? You're on the window? Free Pokemon toy with every Happy Meal. Actually, I can't resist. Let's get that. They have Pikachu, Tepping, Sneevy, and Oshawott toys. How could they do this? They are using me because I am so cute to sell their Death Burgers. Is that a new the McDeath Burger? I haven't had a chance to try that one out yet, but I will have to do that next time I visit. I did not approve of them using my likeness. This is a total violation of my publicity rights. Get me a lawyer. There's someone. Excuse me, sir. Can you help us?
McDonald's customer.
Wow, real-life Pokemon. I love you guys. I love your game so much. You could just slap a Pikachu face on a pinball game and I'd buy it. Wait, they already did that. Is this where they torture and kill living beings and sell them as food items?
They don't kill animals right here, but they sell them as prepared food, and let me tell you, they are delicious.
Okay, so McDonald's customer is me, clearly. The guy who wrote the story and the copy for this game, Joel Bartlett, actually messaged me on Twitter earlier today saying he's a fan of my last playthrough. He thought I should go maybe ease up a little bit on this playthrough, but it seems like he watched my playthrough and then wrote me into the script as this guy here. Because this is literally what I have said before and will say again. Mmm, bacon, I love meat. Chicken nuggets is like my family. It's like I'm saying this out of my own words. You eat animals, but you love Pokemon. I don't understand the difference.
You're not vegans, are you? How do you find a vegan at a dinner party? Don't worry, they'll let you find you.
That was funny. Man, I love meat. Y'all actually kind of tasty, too. I bet you whoever owns you wouldn't mind if I took a bite. If we can farm animals, why not Pokemon, too? Because they're mythical, fictional animals from a video game. That's why. Let's get some feedlots going and grow you real big. I'd be loving it. Mm-mm. Prepare to be downvoted. McDonald's customer attacks battle. Now, see, I have a conflict of interest fighting someone who is the video game embodiment of me, minus the slobby midriff t-shirt. That is not something I would be caught dead wearing. Okay, ooh, let's charge beam. Da-da-da-da-da. Pikachu stunned McDonald's customer with a powerful laser beam. McDonald's customer became paralyzed. He may not be able to move. He uses rant. Nah, nah. He literally wrote this with me in mind. There is no doubt in my mind now. Oh, this is great. I am not even offended. I am just honored. Okay, slam. Pikachu uses slam. Oh, boom. Pikachu courageously slammed the McDonald's customer. McDonald's customer uses bite. Oh, super effective. Pikachu fainted. Let's take in Milf Tank. Let's send him out. No time for a summary. We have to get right back into the battle. Fight. Let's use Utter Madness. A DDoS attack.
Oh, I see. So he's like Edward Snowden.
McDonald's customer dealt a crippling blow to Milf Tank. Uses Utter Madness. Boom! Blast you from my utter. Oh, that was not very good. Milf Tank bamboozled and hurt McDonald's customer. Fight. Bullhorn. Milf Tank uses Bullhorn. Whoa! Milf Tank attacked McDonald's customer with a sonic boom. McDonald's customer can't be confused. He uses bite. Oh no, I don't like bite. That was really effective before. Don't do that again. Do not do that again. Let's fight Zen Headbutt. Boom, right to the crotch. That's my weak spot in real life, just in case you ever come upon me in a battle scene. Super effective. Rant, rant, rant. Blah, blah, blah. I post videos to YouTube. McDonald's customer attack rose. All right, well, I'm just going to Zen Headbutt him again, and that should maybe take him out. Come on, Milf Tank, hold in there. Hang in there, man. We're going to make it to the end of this game.
We have to figure out how we save all the animals and still enjoy our bacon. Because that's what we all want, right? We all want the win-win. We want to treat animals fairly, but also still enjoy meat. Super effective. Let's do one more. Let's do the rollout. Milf Tank turned into a giant rock and then hit McDonald's customer in the ankles.
You've ruined my childhood.
That's a bit dramatic, don't you think?
Pokemon games are supposed to be just for fun. Why do you insist on making everything so serious?
In a world where animals are killed just to satisfy taste buds, don't you think it's important to celebrate kindness over callousness? What if Pokemon did live in this world? From the humans I've seen so far, that ad on the window, I'm afraid that all would be offered to us is exploitation and abuse. Jigglypuff joins the party out of nowhere.
Deus Machina.
Oh no, my favorite Pokemon, Jigglypuff. Don't leave me. Jigglypuff? More like Jiggly Nugget. Let's do Jiggly Nugget. Let's keep it in the family of food here. Jiggly Nugget.
Finally, I'm free. I'm starving. My owner hasn't fed me in a week.
You are looking a little less puffy.
Gah, my owner said he loved me, but he treated me like his property, like a piece of furniture or a toy. He was always playing with me and using me and hanging out with me. I'm so happy to be free. I feel a song coming on.
Maybe later.
Sub.
I was actually hoping for the song. I get a chance to bring out my singing voice.
There are protesters outside of the McDonald's. Team Plasma. They're here to fight for the rights of animals and Pokemon.
I thought Team Plasma was bad. You're confusing me.
Are you with Team Plasma?
No, I'm with PETA. People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. We believe animals are not ours to eat or abuse in any way.
Pokemon too?
Pokemon too.
Wow, you guys sound great.
Swoon.
Are you also attractive? Would you like to hear my new power ballad about Pokemon liberators?
But can you help us stop McDonald's and the humans who have sold us out to promote eating tortured animals? McDonald's is killing animals, and someone is letting them use Pokemon to make people think it's okay.
I can tell you where McDonald's supplier slaughterhouse is. Maybe that will help. And please take this as a good luck charm.
Pikachu found a chest!
Woohoo!
Pikachu opened the chest. A desktop wallpaper was inside. Aw, oh, sweet deal. All right, let's continue. Two slaughterhouse workers surprised the party.
Halt! How did you escape from your cage, cow?
I'm not even a cow. I'm a Milf Tank Pokemon. Thank you very much.
If we can milk you, you're a cow. We've got lots of cheese to make.
My milk is for my babies. Leave me alone.
We're gonna shut this place down. Let's fight.
Oh man, those slaughterhouse workers are... They're something else. All right, let's go to the Zen Headbutt right away.
Oh,
it didn't really do anything. It's not very effective. Pink slime? Aw, gross. Nobody wants to eat that or get sprayed by it. Milf Tank became poisoned. Oh no!
Let's send in Jigglypuff. Send him in.
Not Jigglypuff, Jiggly Nugget. Meat Cleaver? Oh, shoot. Took a bloody swipe at Jiggly Nugget. All right, let's fight. Let's use Shame. What you're doing is wrong and you should feel bad. Your mother wouldn't be proud. Blah, 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 blah. Slaughterhouse workers used cattle prod. They have a lot of attacks up their arsenal, huh? One more time with the lettuce lady. Here it goes!
Jiggly Nugget uses Lettuce Lady, and the workers with a curious bonus salad? I knew we should have gotten a job at the tofu factory. Tofu never fights back. It also tastes like shit.
Let's stop the slaughter line, and I'll free their prisoner.
Grimace joins the party.
Oh,
more like grim ass, am I right? I seriously have a sixth grader's sense of humor. What kind of Pokemon is that? Maybe it's a shiny Snorlax?
No, I'm a rare Grimace Pokemon. I was a mutation created by McDonald's decades ago to convince children to eat their food made of tortured animals.
So he's the living embodiment of the McNugget, apparently. Does he come with sweet and sour sauce? Because that's always the way to do it.
McDonald's doesn't use me in their Happy Meals anymore. Now they lure kids in with their most popular Pokemon. They use cuteness to cover that they are doing evil. I'm surprised they didn't capture me. I'm definitely in the top percentage of Jigglypuff.
Together we can stop the evil McDonald's Corporation and help everyone go vegan.
This way.
Really? Everyone? Everyone vegan?
You're talking about putting billions of dollars of corporations and things out of money, out of business. Like, people, farmers, what would they do for a living?
Nothing.
Ash, what are you doing here?
I heard you were in trouble. I followed you through the portal and ran into some people from this really awesome organization, PETA, who said you went this way. They gave me this awesome t-shirt.
Oh.
Thanks for the offer of help, Ash, but we've got this one covered.
Good to hear, and I just hope you can help the people in this world the way you helped me. Okay, well, at least PETA got this part right. I feel like they kind of missed that message in the last parody game, which is they made Ash Ketchum out to be like this asshole, when Ash is actually on the side of the Pokemon. He's a good guy, and at least it seems like here they actually portrayed him that way, so that's nice. Teach them how they gotta free them all, but hey, there might be intel in here to help you. Let's open the chest and find out about this intel. You've unlocked the Pokemon Red, White, and Blue in unofficial PETA parody trading cards. Download now. I'm gonna print those out and play with my friends. No, I'm not that stupid. I hope they captured my puffy side. Oh, that's disgusting, Jiggly Nugget. All your sides are puffy. That's even more disgusting. Well, you flatter me. Whoa! Ronald McDonald, you've looked better.
I see you freed the Grimace. It's of no concern. Kids today have never even heard of me. You cute Pokemon would really sell our burgers. Because of you, we've sold millions more burgers, chicken nuggets, and Filet-O-Fishes made of your dead animal friends to children who love you. And have had all semblance of empathy eaten away by your incessant, monotonous fighting games.
This is for all tortured, Torchic, and mutilated Magikarp.
Magikarp, really?
A great darkness appears.
Battle.
How do I bring my other Pokemon back into the fight? I'm gonna put him to sleep with my singing.
Jiggly Nugget uses sing.
Oh no, right in my balls.
Jiggly Nugget warbled a sulfuric melody at Ronald McDonald, and he fell asleep. Let's send in a Grimace and see what he can do.
Go, Grimace.
Fight!
Poison jab!
Yes. Does anyone actually remember Grimace, the Pokemon, the mascot for McDonald's that was like this giant, like, purple cookie monster type thing? I do, but I'm old. Grimace aimed a toxic punch at Ronald McDonald, and it's not very effective. McPunishment! Pikachu's almost dead. We have to stay in this fight. Let's do charge beam one more time. Come on. Electrify those balls of his.
Yes! Yes!
Pikachu stunned Ronald McDonald. Let's see who's behind this clown mask anyways.
Why, you're just a man!
Not just a man, a very rich man. And until you and your little friends showed up, and your stupid dog, too, with your message of kindness for all beings, whatever happened to exploit Pokemon for profit? I miss Team Rocket. I didn't intend for that to rhyme, but it did.
Remember how I used the global terminal to encourage Pokemon liberation? Maybe we could share the McDonald's footage we found on this world communication platform to help people realize they are being duped by a giant corporation into thinking Pokemon and animals are theirs to exploit and kill.
Yes, we need to share this footage on the Facebook.
My old owner never stopped talking about the legendary Pokemon called Reddit. That's actually pretty clever.
We should share it with Reddit, too. And with PETA, they just seem so amazing. Oh.
Do you think people will stop supporting McDonald's and go vegan if they see this footage? Not likely. If they understand how animals suffer? Not likely.
Yes, even humans can evolve.
Very slowly, though. Very, very slowly.
Congratulations, you've won!
You've uncovered the evil conspiracy to use cute cartoon characters to destroy kids' empathy and sell food from tortured animals. If you believe in promoting empathy over exploitation, speak up for Pokemon Animal Liberation by sharing the message of kindness for all beings. And stay tuned for Pokemon Purple, a PETA parody, a re-release of this game with no noticeable improvements because it wouldn't be Pokemon if we didn't milk this thing for all it's worth. If we didn't soy milk this thing. That's a bit of a jab at Nintendo for releasing the same game twice. But, hey, I kind of agree with that one. Play again and type in PETA one time during battle to call in some special help.
Ooh!
So you heard it here first. If you want to play this game, you now have a bit of a cheat code. Type in the word parody. But we are finished, so let's check out the treasure and see what we have here. Oh, that's all the stuff we collected along the way. Let's check out the credits for the game. Oh, look at all this stuff right here. Oh, that is so swell. All those great people from This Is Pop helped make Pokemon Red, White, and Blue, an unofficial PETA parody possible. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing and or clicking the like button and leaving a comment. I would greatly appreciate it. This has been fun. Again, at the end of the day, I understand the message. I agree with it to an extent, but I do love my bacon, I do love my beef, and I will keep eating it. I just hope it can come from a place where they're not torturing animals. But I appreciate the entertainment, PETA. It has been fun as always. And to you, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.